Hi everyone, I hope everything is good. We are here today for the player analysis of 11 of the best players under 21 who were elected by the Sorare community and who are playing in the Euro under 21. So, let's start now! Our goalkeeper today is Alban Lafont. Lafont is someone who started turning heads at a very young age. At only 16 years old, he made his debut for Toulouse in Ligue 1. In his first season in the French First Division, he only allowed 27 goals in 24 games. He also managed to keep 8 clean sheets that season. In his second season, he stepped up his game. He upped his saving percentage by a whopping 15%. This put him at an amazing 80% saving rate. With his great performance, he pushed Toulouse to the 30th place that season. He had one more solid season with Toulouse before they decided to sell him to AFC Fiorentina. This was quite surprising as there was alleged interest from some top clubs such as Arsenal. Despite his market value being at 18 million, Fiorentina was able to pick him up for only 8 million. After a season in which he struggled a bit in the Serie A, he returned to Ligue 1 to Nantes on loan. After two very good seasons, Nantes and Fiorentina are currently discussing about a potential transfer this summer. Moving on to the defense, we have two Ligue 1 players, but we'll start with someone from Liganos. On the right back position, Pedro Porro, the 21-year-old Spaniard, made his debut for Girona in Spain at only 18 years old. He started for a struggling Girona team and did everything in his power to keep them in La Liga. His efforts didn't save Girona from relegation, as they finished 80th. Porro himself was bought by Manchester City, but immediately loaned out to Valladolid. After a disappointing season in which he only appeared in 7 games, he decided to move on to a completely different league to find his form as Manchester City loaned him to Sporting Portugal. Porro became a huge contributor on Sporting, who are currently in first place in the Liga NOS. Our central defender is someone on which we have done a full player analysis in the past. Sven Botman is an incredible Dutch defender who plays for Lille. If you want to know more about his game, make sure to check out our player analysis video about him, as he is truly a remarkable player. After only one season in the Dutch First Division, Lille realized his potential and immediately scooped him away from Heerenveen. He is already very mature despite his young age, and his ability to win aerial duels make him a force to be reckoned with in the box. There were some doubters as he was asked to lead the defense in Lille, but he proved everyone wrong as they are currently sitting in second place. As our final defensive player, the Sorare community chose Boubacar Camara, who is currently also playing in Ligue 1 as a defensive midfielder, who occasionally plays center and left back for the team in fixed place Olympique Marseille. Camara is a real Marseille boy. He was born there on November 99 and has lived there his whole life. He started playing for Olympique Marseille Academy at only 5 years old. He made his way through the ranks before making his professional debut playing for Marseille 2 in 2016. A season later, he made his debut for their first team. By impressing his coach, he became their go-to starter in 2018 at only 18 years old. In his 3 seasons as a starter, Camara has been very impressive, as he became the stronghold of Marseille's defense. our little streak of League One players comes to an end, as we move on to the midfield where we find another Pedro who plays for Sporting Portugal. Attacking midfielder Pedro Gonçalves has had quite an interesting career path. This young Portuguese started his career in his hometown Chaves, but he spent most of his youth career developing in Braga before moving on to Valencia. After that, he decided to take his talents to England where he played for Wolves under 23 in the English second division. Surprisingly, he returned to Portugal as a free agent. Of course, the move back to his home country was not surprising, but the choice of team, the recently promoted Famalicão. He immediately became their starting right winger and he was a big reason for Famalicão's immediate success in the Liga NOS, as they became fixed in their first season in Portugal's top football league. His play was quickly recognized by Portugal's top team as Sporting swept him away for 6.5 million after only one season. As we continue on our midfield, we find a talented defensive midfielder in Belgium. The 22-year-old Niklas Dorsch, who started his career for Bayern, has immediately found his stride in the Jupiler Pro League, despite playing for the struggling KAA Gent. Dorsch is a Bayern youth product who didn't quite break through in the first team. This is why he spent the last two seasons in the German second league. But he got his chance in Belgium and he immediately proved everyone his potential. In only 27 games, he already racked up 64 tackles and 32 interceptions. He's becoming a must-have player for any team who wants a high-impact defensive midfielder. We stay in the Benelux as our next defensive midfielders play for AZ Alkmaar. Ten Koopmeiners has become one of the best midfielders in the Eredivisie, who managed to keep AZ tightly locked in the top 5 over the 4 past seasons. He was always a great defender, but throughout the years, he also managed to step up his offensive game. He has improved his scoring total every year and is starting to draw interest from top European clubs. If you want a more in-depth analysis about this incredible prospect, make sure to check out our player analysis about him. Our final midfielder is someone who plays for one of the biggest clubs in the world. Curtis Jones is a Liverpool youth product who rose through the ranks before making his debut for the first team last season. In that Czech team that won the Premier League that year, he could not really find a steady role as a central midfielder, but all that changed this season. Jurgen Klopp must have liked what he saw from Jones in the first few games, as he became their regular starter in a Liverpool squad that was depleted by injuries. At only 19 years old, Liverpool seemed to have found someone who can lead their midfield for the next decade. Jones is already very good, but his room for improvement seems unlimited. For our next three players, we go back across the North Sea. Club Brugge's Noah Lang has made quite an entrance this season. Lang was quite an unknown player despite coming from Ajax's renowned youth academy. He didn't really get any playing chances in the Eredivisie, which is why Ajax decided to loan him to Club Brugge. In 22 games, Lang has scored 11 times while also assisting on 6 other goals. His impact as a left-wing attacker is truly unbelievable. Brugge didn't think a second as they pick up his buying option for only 6 million euros. This was an incredible steal as his market value skyrocketed to 20 million over the course of this season. For our striker, we have to return to AZ Alkmaar. The 20-year-old Myron Boadu is becoming one of the most dangerous players in the Eredivisie. In his first season as a starting striker, Boadu ended up in a tied third place for top scorer in the Eredivisie. he was only one goal away from first place. He built on that strong season by already scoring 12 goals in 24 games this season. The interesting mix of being a crafty striker but also solid passers leads to a very interesting prospect. He still has to develop quite a bit, but the raw talent is there. This should not be a problem, as AZ Alkmaar has proven that they are very capable at developing young talent. Our final player is a French striker who plays for Nice. Amine Gouiri earned his starting job this season after making his debut for Lyon 2 seasons ago. His move to Nice was the right move in his career, as he only started one game for Lyon last season. Nice picked him up for only 7 million, but it already seems like one of the biggest mistakes for Lyon's history. In only 29 games, he already scored 12 goals while also giving 6 assists. On top of that, his value also jumped to 20 million. At only 20 years old, it will be very interesting where his career will go from here. In conclusion, all of these 11 young guns have the potential to become some of the best players in the world. But of course, there are gonna be some busts, while others may be a home run. Finding young talent is one thing, but properly developing is another. That's the end of today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If this is the case, don't forget to share it around you and to subscribe. If you want to learn more about Sorare, you can join us on our Discord server. If you want to join Sorare, you can use our link in the description. If you use it, you will earn one rare card as soon as you buy 5 rare cards on the primary market. So if you do it, thanks a lot, it will help the channel. I wish you good luck, and until next time, take care.